My name is Diegetseng Prudence Njobokwane. I'm a 31-year-old young lady who's very enthusiastic and looking forward to living. I'm a mother, a former firefighter, former beneficiary to the WOF program. I grew up in a small township on the outskirts of Kagiso in the Krugersdorp in the west end of Gauteng. I come from a family of 5 children, and we were raised by my mother single-handedly, and she was working as a domestic, and she used to struggle a lot just raising the 5 of us. We would go to school even if it was raining, and we would walk about 24 kilometers on a daily basis. But that just taught me something about life, that life is not going to be handed. Good things are not going to be handed to you. You have to go fetch your life. I remember this one day, just after I finished my matric in 2007, my sister wanted to stay with me, but she wasn't sure. She was living in the Krugersdorp Fire Department barracks with her husband, now late, passed away in 2014. And so finally, when she eventually invited me over to her house, which was at the fire department, this one day I noticed that there was like a group of people queuing up. I just didn't understand what was happening. So I tried to inquire via a neighbor, and she told me that there was a recruitment process of working on fire that was taking place. I registered, and I remember I was amongst the late ones who registered. I almost didn't participate, but then I ran like I never ran in my life, and yeah, I made it. The push-ups, the sit-ups, I did the proper boy one, so that they knew that if they didn't pick me, they were going to be missing out on not just a leader, but one who would make sure that every firefighter comes back from the fire line alive. Your amazing experience of my life. Right now, as a professional nurse, I'm seated in a specific unit. I love my job, but it's nowhere near firefighting, because every day you would anticipate a new circumstance, a new call, you know, to go put off a fire somewhere. And that was just a great experience, like that thrill, that adrenaline rush for me. And just knowing that you have, not only have you saved lives, you have saved livestock, you have saved property. For me, it just felt like I was doing something positive towards the betterment of my country. I remember this one time when I was part of the IC, the IC command structure for the Azisha Games in 2012. The Azisha Games was held at Zonnerwater prison, if I recall well. And there I got to meet Mr. Trevor Abrahams for the first time. And it was like on the fields where we were playing soccer, some were doing archery, and he was specifically teaching archery. So from his leadership skills, I've learned so much, from a test of endurance, you know, patience and resilience. And for that, I'm forever grateful. He is one man I have grown to understand that he is so, so passionate about working on fire that he will defend it with the very last breath, if you may allow me to put it that way. He loves the firefighter so much so that when he comes or when he makes contact with a firefighter, everything else stops. I don't care who you are, where you're coming from, whether you're a manager of another company or whatever, but when a firefighter comes, he wants to listen to the firefighter and create that rapport with the firefighter and understand the needs of the firefighter. So he's very passionate. And from that is why I'm forever drawn back to working on fire, because I always felt at home here. At a time where the whole world is in need of nurses, you know, I'm so humbled and honored. And even though I had just completed my studies, I just remembered one thing that I took from working on fire, that you can never be ready to be on the fire line. Where there is smoke, there is fire. I learned a lot about people's skills, you know, working together as a team, that you can never, there is no I in we, you know, and that it takes each and every individual's effort to fulfill the organization's goal or vision. So for me, it has taught me teamwork, because even on the fire line, I don't care how fit you are, if you don't listen to the crew leader, you will burn on the fire line. same as in nursing. And nursing is continuity of care. When I leave my shift, I leave the patients under the care of the nurse that's just coming in. So it's very imperative that there's open communication amongst us as colleagues, and that we understand that we don't have to be the best of friends, but we just have to do what needs to be done, and which is keeping the patients alive and keeping the fires at bay. Yeah.